Well, hello everyone, and welcome to the channel. Am I recording? Okay. All right. Hey, everyone. I hope everything's going all right. Here, let me check something. Testing. Testing. All right. Well, had a little bit of lag there. Anyway, hail and well met, everyone. Welcome to the channel. Welcome back to the world of Dungeons and Dragons Online. Normally, I would be in Eberron, but now I'm in one of the many realms. This one being the Feywild. And dancing right now because going to a party. And so I got my fine clothes on. And off I go to the party. To Bitter Spring Pal Bitter Spine Palace. First, I thought it's, I misread it. I thought it was Butter Spine, but whoa. Whoa, whoa, whoa. What? Oh, God. Oh, hell. Son of a buck. No, I'm not going to kill Mr. Fox. If anyone pops in the channel and can hear my voice, let me know. Oh, Lord. Oh, come on, I might as well. Alrighty. Well, that's that. So I am continuing the Feywild quests. What is that? Oh God. Oh my God, what the hell? Okay. Okay. Another kill. Oh, crap. Goblins, and there are red cats in the area. Spider? Oh my God. Over the freaking place. Thank you. See, what's this one? Well, not just yet. I'm not gonna do that one yet. But there's a walk up I need to do, so. Ooh.
Whether this structure was meant to be a shelter, a temple, or just a decorative addition to the view.
Oh. Well, it's a nice view. Okay, got some fairies. I mean, no, not fairies. Got some, that's right. Death from above. Whoa. That deflection ability I got through. I think it's that. Wait a second. It is. Arcane encumbrance. Basically, if someone hits me with a spell, I can. It. There's a 30% chance, I think, that I'll deflect it back to them. And here we got some warhounds. Oh, that one. Okay. Well, I thought I was going up. Polar bears? Polar bears. And of course, I have. Oh God! Well, they're not the friendly polar bears you see in the Coca-Cola ads around Christmas time. Oh no! Oh no! No, they're not.
Within the distance of just a few short steps, the temperature plummets and snow covers the ground. Whatever caused this sudden change in the climate surely wasn't natural.
See, do I go up this way? Damn satyrs. There we go. Ooh. Your wolves, of course. This is beautiful. Got a Formarian here. And another for Marion.
Oh,
leave those polar bears alone. But I will kill all the satyrs. Okay, so this is... Let's see what this is. Ice Mount Lodge. Okay, I'm going to... Well, I hope all of you are having a wonderful Saturday evening. Or Sunday morning, wherever you are in the world. Getting ready for the dreaded time change. I hate daylight savings time.
Bitterspine Palace, home to the Baron and Baroness Bitterspine, in one of the many holdings of the Prince of Frost.
Okay. Okay, Odor, I seek a frosted cerise flower. Please let me in. I should go one above, but I'll do this. I'll go elite next time. Same time.
You have arrived at Bitterspine Palace, home of one of the Prince of Frost's vassals. You proceed with caution. Whether you're expected by the Baroness or not, the Prince of Frost's cold reputation is known throughout the Feywild.
Oh, that's nifty. Okay.
The Prince of Frost stands before a throne overlooking the crowded ballroom, the Baroness beside him. However, the third throne on the dais stands empty. The air chills as the Archfey points a finger toward you.
Why have you disturbed me with your presence, Outlander?
If I may, my prince, says the Baroness. A connection in the summer court sent word of the Outlander's arrival. I have granted them an audience with me. I assure you, they will not disturb the ball.
All right. Your Highness. Hold on, what are you talking about? What about the empty throne? What happened to the Baron? I'll track down.
The frosted cerise has miraculously sprung up inside the Aurora Garden. You're told that Osha loathes extravagant parties such as this one. He's likely to be avoiding the crowd somewhere, perhaps out on the windward balcony.
Oh, they're dancing. Well, hey, when in Rome. Oh, no, maybe not that. A little too... God. Whoa. All right, let's do it this way. There we go. We're dancing. Dancing away. Dance, DDO style. DDO dance party. Saturday night. We used to do that back in the day. We used to have dance parties in front of the fountain there in the marketplace. Okay. North wing.
This door leads out to the windward balcony. Dim gems on either side. You can see that it has been sealed to prevent guests from following OSHA outside.
Oh, we got it here. Okay, we can help each other out.
Squire Icebrook asks you to bring an urgent message to the Baroness. For reasons he will not divulge, this must remain a secret from the Prince of Frost.
Okay. Feel kind of uneasy running around armed.
The Baroness refuses to take your message in front of the Prince and all her guests. She tells you to meet her downstairs.
Sorry, in the wine cellar. Had to readjust. I take it this is the way down to the wine cellar. Or is it over here? So now I'm getting into some palace intrigue. Head waiter.
The door to the treasure vault is bolted shut. Perhaps one of the wait staff knows how to get inside.
Oh, wait a second. Here we go. All right. Okay. Hunting lodge, okay. All right.
A wave of relief washes over the Baroness's face as she scans the letters. The Baron is alive and safe. Whatever he got himself into has kept him away from home.
Okay.
The head waiter explains that OSHA told him not to allow anyone into the treasure vault. However, you're able to persuade the goblin to unlock the door.
Oh, God.
Water element flood out of the treasure vault
I had to get in here anyway.
You hear a bell chime in the ballroom as you pull this lever.
Welcome to the channel. Don't be shy. And if you can hear me, let me know. Had some weird lag at the beginning. Anyway, let's see. I don't use those Kenneth essences. All right, I guess there's. Don't see anything disturbing here, well, so far. Okay. Little chai tea. Okay. Well, all right, folks. Hope you're doing well. Let's see what's over here. Hold on a second. Okay. Oh, I don't know if I should. Oh, God. Seriously?
Didn't think anyone would dare to intrude in the Prince of Frost's private quarters. You find yourself in a surprisingly sparse chamber, but even in such a bare room, you know there must be something hidden inside.
Okay, got an adventurer's pack. Should I what? Do a spot? Okay. Well, I can't find anything. Okay. All right, so nothing is. Wait a second.
The spout on this fountain turns like a door handle. Secret passage slides open along the back wall. Hidden away in this room stands a sculpture of a woman. Its plaque reads, "For my love, in ice you survive."
That it? Should I?
Of his long lost love.
Oh God. Well, okay, well. Okay, well. Oh, okay. Okay, well, yeah. Okay. Okay, all right, so now I need, excuse me. Okay, so looks like we got a little bit of gambling going on. Okay. Oh, yeah. Let me I believe I went down this way. Where is that guy? Where did I thought I met, no. All right, did I, Okay. think I went. Well, everyone. Okay, I gotta find where that lever is. Where did I run into that bastard? Okay. He was at the top of some stairs, I think. All right, this is. Oh, wait a second. Okay. There he is. Okay, he sings me a song, like, what the hell?
Squire Icebrook promised to give you something older than the palace as payment for delivering his message to the Baroness. Getting a rendition of an old folk song wasn't exactly what you had in mind.
No, it wasn't.
Find yourself in a small corridor that has been frozen over with ice. The icicles block the door leading into the Baron's room, clearly to deter someone from going inside.
Nothing here. Cripes. Oh, well, great. Okay. Notice no fireplaces? Yeah. Oh. Is that what I... Okay. getting the hang of this. Okay. No, I think I can go out here. Okay.
The court advisor stares off into the distance. At the sound of your footsteps, he jolts, turns around, and lets out a dejected sigh.
The Baroness sent me here after your guard key. Okay. I'm glad we understand each other.
OSHA hands you a key. He tells you that the frosted cerise flower can be found in the center of the Aurora Garden, but warns you not to let the true nature of your visit become gossip fodder for the other guests.
Oh my. Okay. Don't mind me smashing. Okay. No, that's not what I wanted to do. And they're dancing, and they're dancing, and they're dancing. Did I just... passed it by. Okay.
You step out into the snowy garden. A peculiar patch of grass grows in its center. Along with a flower that emanates a magical, chilly aura. Crumples away into nothing in the palm of your hand, and instantly regrows in the soil. The newly sprouted flower glows blindingly for a moment, and, unexpectedly, a shockwave rocks the palace.
Oh, God.
Something blocking it from the other side. You need to find another way out of the garden.
Great.
something blocking it from the other side. We need to find another way out of the garden.
Okay. 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 Nothing. Whoa. Do I need to climb out? Wait a second. Oh, don't tell me. Don't tell me. Oh. Okay. Oh God. Okay.
To your surprise, the ballroom is now covered in twisting vines and familiar flowers.
I thought I eradicated those flowers a millennia ago. Now they're everywhere.
Snarled the Prince of Frost.
Outlander, you will fix this. I'll turn you into a block of ice.
Lord Barrel and Dame.
Informs you that there were only two Eladrin nobles she didn't recognize in attendance tonight. She knows who can tell you more. Sir Snowdrift, the resident social butterfly of the Prince of Frost's court.
Hmm. Come on. There it is. Okay. You must be Sir Snowdrift. Who are Lord Beryl and Dame Allegra? Okay, but Beryl has seen her.
Snowdrift tells you that Lord Beryl was last seen slinking off to the kitchen in search of a fresh bottle of wine. Then he shoos you out of his crowd of adoring nobles.
Oi! I'm not interested in failing her dance card.
Lord Beryl says that Dame Allegra has gone to explore the Prince of Frost's quarters. Speaking with her is the next step in solving this current puzzle.
Oh my.
Stands at the base of the stairs that lead to the Princess Frost's quarters. This must be Dame Allegra, the mysterious newcomer you're looking for.
Okay. All right. Okay. Beryl told me you would be here. Okay, you know anything about these flowers popping up all over the place?
Dame Allegra saw a hooded stranger plant the frosted cerise in the garden. She bids you to follow her there, so she can help you search for clues about the culprit.
Tells me she... Oh, come on! Guys are really starting to annoy me.
A growth of blossoming vines has sprung up around the tree. When you get close, it comes back. Dame Allegra stands in the center of the garden.
I knew it.
She lets out a low chuckle.
How did you like my little prank? It was good fun, right? That gloomy prince always entertains my master here, sir.
Allegra turns to me.
See me, dearie. Good. It'll be for the last time.
Peyton's pants.
Yeah, I think there's enough tossing for one day. I'll let my pretty finish you off.
The mad cackle. The frosted cerise flower from the snow. This time, the bloom stays in the palm of your hand, instead of crumpling away into nothing. Return to the Baroness to tell her what happened.
Okay, alright, so now she knows. Okay, I'll try not to. Alright, take care.
Never admit to it. The Baroness tells you. He is in your debt for thwarting the Night Hag's scheme. And now that you have the frosted cerise, you're one step closer to waking Lord Arden.
Okay. Maybe I should.
Ahead lies Bitterspine Palace, home to the Baron and Baroness Bitterspine, and one of the many holdings of the Prince of Frost.
All right, so I think I can get into here. Yes. Okay. Okay. There we go. Oh, thank you, Lady Borealis. Borealis. Let's take this. Okay, let's sell. Repair. Okay. What's that? What's next? Okay. Oh, there he is. Oh, God. I hate these pixies. Okay, who knows? Oh, God. Wake me up before I go. Great.
You awake from your unexpected slumber. At first, things seem as before. You're still at Wynwood Hall, and Melody is still standing beside the bed. Then you realize that Lord Arden is missing, and so are the flower and the lute you need for the ritual.
I'm going to ask you if you know his true name, but it's pretty clear that you're not here to help. What did you do with Lord Arden?
Melody begins speaking in a familiar voice.
Lord Arden.
Oh, God.
Of course I know it. But it's for me to know and for you to never get. Now, be a good adventurer and die to monsters in the wilderness while I go make sure Lord Arden never, ever wakes up.
She cackles as she teleports away.
Good God. Oh, hell.
Creatures milling around near the gate to Wynwood Hall. Then you notice that things seem different. This isn't the Feywild. You are trapped inside a dream. In the corner of the courtyard stands a Kushi. It bears its fangs at you as you approach. You approach a shadowy form that appears to be Lord Arden, reading a note with a worried expression on his face. The figure doesn't notice your presence. The shadowy Lord Arden fades into nothing. Based on his appearance and your uncanny surroundings, you guess that you must be inside the Lord's nightmare.
Inside the magically sealed gazebo ahead floats the frosted cerise you need for the ritual. Three bears rest outside. Magical talking bears, no doubt. This is the Feywild.
Oh, God. You guys didn't even give me a chance to talk to you. Just
recovered the frosted cerise for the ritual.
Just wanted to talk. Okay. Okay, so shoot. Okay. 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 Nope. Nope, not letting me get back there, up there. There it is. Okay, good. Good, 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 good. The loot.
Movement underneath the bridge. Moving closer, you see a nasty looking troll.
Okay.
You've recovered Hearsome's loot for the ritual. You've recovered both the loot and the frosted cerise. Now, where has Melody hidden Lord Arden? You notice a pillar of magical energy streaming from a distant portal. Perhaps that contains the secret.
Okay. 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 So there is. So where is this? Oh, that's just airy. Wait a second. Okay. All right. You have my word.
You've reluctantly decided to allow Cadence to live in exchange for Lord Arden's true name.
Let's get goodness.
Lay out the ingredients for the ritual and repeat the steps to reverse the curse. First, play the lute. Then, grind up the flower's roots. Last, burn the roots along with Lord Arden's true name. You play a brief melody on Hearsome's lute. You mash the flower's roots into a pulp with little effort. You set a small blaze, then drop the crushed roots and Lord Arden's true name into it, completing the ritual. As the smoke rises, Lord Arden's eyes open. He springs out of the bed.
All right. Well, you're welcome. I'm glad to help.
Lord Arden thanks you for awakening him from this curse. He urges you to speak with him back at Wynwood Hall in the waking world.
Hey guys, how you doing? Hope I just saw that you were there. Everything's going fine. Hello everyone. Hope you all doing okay. So did you have fun, Irina? I think God said I can finish. Yeah, I can. I'm just finishing up, I think, the main Feywild quest right now. So, okay. Ooh. There he is. All right, my lord. Okay, what was he trying to accomplish here, okay? Okay. Okay. All righty. Yeah, I have to admit, you know, it's nice to it's nice to run with a group sometimes, but I tell you, there's a lot to be said when you're running solo. You can run at your own pace. Okay. Okay. Still having internet issues, Link. Let's see. Oh, wait a second, I gotta talk to. But yeah, I have to admit that Alright, I got that done. Nope, don't want to repeat it. So, again, welcome everyone. And this is my... how I spend my nights at times. Usually I am... oh, well, wait a second. Yeah, I know. It's still kind of sucks, though. I have to say that we've been pretty lucky. We have Spectrum, and actually, I mean, we haven't had any serious issues in a while, but you know, that just might change. Oh God, I hate the look of that. You know, so I'm doing the, this is my first time going through the, Feywild, and I like it so far. I'm kind of stumbling around here and there, but, you know, I'm having fun. Yeah, it can be very frustrating. Here, hold on a second. Let's go ahead and max this out. Okay. No. You know, years ago, I remember... I think it was the city of Chattanooga that offered its own high-speed internet. And I think, in fact, it was fiber optic. And it was offered as a city. Okay. Okay. All right. Okay. All right. What do I need to do? Oh yeah. The city of Chattanooga was offering high-speed fiber optical internet, something like that. The upload download speeds, everything was just insane, and it was better than what the commercial internet providers were doing. And they were doing it at a very cheap rate, and people got upset about it. But, you know, I mean, they could have, you know, they can go and, you know, compete if they want to. I think we pay about, okay, I forgot what I was going to do. I think we pay, oh God, I want to say 149, I don't know. We pay, we got a bundle at a small rate. I mean, at a decent rate for now. But it was, had to get a phone line too. Oh, there we go. Oh God, that's right. I was going to check in my mail.
This soaring structure is Winwood Hall, the home of Lord Arden and the local center of the summer court.
Where's the mailbox? Oh, right over here. Oh, God. God, goblins freaked me out. Krusa? I gotta speak with her, I guess. Okay. Oh, there she is. Hello there. All right. Well, that's cool. Anyway, yeah, I know it's having really kind of shite. Where it all? There we go. Having shite internet is not fun. After the fire, when we were at the actors' apartments there at the Shakespeare Festival, we had, well, you know, my wife used to work IT there, and the internet there was just amazing. And then we spent the last 4 months at the hotel before we got here, and the internet was just, I mean, it was fine, but I mean, you know, I was just starting out with a YouTube channel. Oh, okay. All right, Link. Hey, thanks for stopping in. Have a good one, man. I forgot, you guys are, it's a little late back there. Good Lord, you're probably close with the time change. I am not going to kill a deer like that. Although I do like my venison. Oh, wait a sec. Oh, come on. All right. Ouch. I love the headbutts. Okay. God damn. Long John Silver's closed, assholes. Same goes for the Red Lobster. Red Lobster's closed. Yeah. Yeah, I just... Oh, bloody boo. I just remembered that when I lived in Cleveland, you know, that was... we were Eastern time zone, so... So, yeah, that was, you know, so, yeah. Well, that's like here in Oregon, where I was born, in Eastern Oregon, in Ontario. That's in Mountain Time Zone. And of course, we're Pacific here. Nebraska, where my family is at now. I mean, most of the state is in. They're in Central Time Zone, but the eastern half, the Panhandle, is in. There, I love that. Who's trying to? Oh God. Yeah. I'd love to do a flying hit. What are you guys? You're archers, but you got violins, fiddles. Good lord. No, I shouldn't be complaining about that. Oh. Woads. I've said it once, I'll say it again. I love how the animations they have for the Displacer Beast. What was that? Okay, blink dog. Let's see. Da, 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 da. So are you going to be streaming tomorrow, Irina? Oh, God. Winter Wolves. Cursor, Feywild Winterworld, but same thing. I hate Ether Cats. I never thought there was something more loathsome than a kobold, but the red cats are, they're getting there. Wakey, wakey. Oh my God. Damn, three wild harpies. Okay. Where's this? Oh god, they're just hanging there. What the hell? Oh look, dancing satyrs. They must die. I got my head. Satyr Exterminator 1. Yes. Okay, who we got here? Goblins. Okay. So a little background information for some of you who have just joined in. I've been playing DDO since October of 2009. Right after, I think that's when they started their free to play. Okay. Let's see. Let me take a look at things. Okay. Looking good. Looking good. Oh, that's my bio. Okay, everything's looking good.
Snow drifts into the open gateway of the abandoned lodge. You spot Hirsam, the prince of satyrs, through the gate.
We meet again, Bear. I see you're still here, carrying out your duties.
You know that I am bound to this place, Prince. It was your command.
You don't seem very enthusiastic about it. As it happens, I'm about to have a very important meeting here, and I don't wish to be disturbed. I'll need some guards. Reliable guards, not a grumpy old flea bag like yourself. Let's see.
Oh god, that's good.
Do it. Don't bother to get up, Bear. I wouldn't want to interrupt your busy schedule.
God, that's a real.
The bear looks up at you. He's known you were there all along.
You might as well come in.
He grumbles as he opens the gate.
Okay. Maybe I can win this guy over. I don't know. Okay. Well, hey, thanks for the raid. I really appreciate it. And if I don't talk to you guys soon, have a good Sunday. You know, I hope you enjoy the rest of the weekend. So take care, you crazy kids. And be seeing you later on. Okay. Oh, three things. Oh, God. Why is it? Oh, God. There's always three things. Sap of a sky oak. Owlbear butter. Owlbear butter?
The bear agrees to help you find the Baron, but first you must bring him 3 items.
All right, take care, guys. Owlbear butter. What the hell? Oh, God. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Okay. Here it is. Oh, I got a trap too. Fire traps. So anyway, I've been playing since 2009. I'm here on Sarlona. I'm a member of the Griffin's Nest Guild. Back in the day, we used to be something. Oh, we're starting to build up again. Oh. And I've... Typically, I've always played Halflings. I did try, Elves early on, but, oh God! Oh God! Oh God! The dialogue in this. Has he been trying around? How do I get underground? I'm on a schedule. Not being rude. I'm chaotic good. Good intentions, but questionable methods. And of course, no one gives me a straight answer. Never with the straight answers. Let's try again. All right. Did I go in here? Yeah, I think I did. Let's take a look at the map. Of course that. Oh, whoa.
The portal flickers to life, and a dark figure steps through.
Here you are, Archfey. I have come. As you requested.
What the hell?
Have you obtained the Codex Tejas?
Aren't
Naturally, naturally. No, it took some doing. The mortals gave my hacks a bit of trouble, but once I was concealed by the enchantment, I was able to make off with the pages and leave those druids none the wiser.
Then let us be done with this. Hand over the pages.
Now, let's not get ahead of ourselves. There are two sides to this deal. And how can I be sure that you'll deliver your promise?
You ask much. You wish to transform the entire Feywild.
Who is it?
Oh, I wish to restore the Feywild. Return it to what it was before the Aladrin littered with carts and palaces. This was once a place of unfettered freedom, touched only by the pure hand of nature.
Nature? Yes, you needn't worry about that. I have found a place that civilization has never touched. A place where nature is unbounded. All you need do is open the door.
Oh, this is not good. This is not good.
You keep talking about this door, well and good. But what I need is the key.
The key is my secret for now. You'll receive it when the time is right. We will arrange one more meeting where we'll make our exchange. Yet, as you seem impatient, so I have brought a gift. Corrupted you.
Oh my god.
Breed found nowhere in this place. You'll find they make effective servants.
Effective spies, you mean. But no worries.
Jeez.
I'm sure.
Remember, Archfey, you're not the only one who can do me this service. Yet if you fulfill your word, I will fulfill mine. Farewell.
Son of a bitch. Unicorns as it is, annoy me. Now we have corrupted. Oh, God. Oh, God. How? Is that a glitch or what? What the hell? Oh, dance form. Okay. Alrighty, let's. I love that arcane encumbrance. Best thing, one of the nice things I love about the occult slayer enhancement. He's gonna have questions, and I don't have the answers right now. Wait a second. Hmm. Have I gone through here yet? Take a look. Okay. Okay. I thought, wait a second. Choice. Okay. There's got to be something else around here. Nope. All right, let's go around here. Okay. Seriously, there's got to be. There's got to be something. All right. Wait a second. Which way did I go? So this way. Oh, wait a second. Oh, nice vendor trash there. I knew I missed a spot. Okay, is this the grove? Oh, we got it. Has to be the grove or something close to it. Okay, the sky oak.
Open the door and step into the massive sky oak, only to find yourself plummeting downward.
Okay. And here we have the evil Groots. Well, not. Well, there's an evil Groot. And here's another evil Groot. Okay. Get away from me, evil Groot. Okay. And, oh, wait, look, it's a puzzle. Okay, so take it, we don't want to connect to these things. town. Wait a second. Or maybe I do need to. Okay, fine. Oh. Okay, great. Is this a one-time thing? God. Swamp Thing and Evil Groot. Okay, never had a feeling. Oh, God. Let's take a look at this. Oh, wait a second. Great.
Of sky oak sap seeps out of the massive sea. Pick up the sticky sap. What could the bear possibly want with this?
I don't know. Okay. Oh, looky. What is that?
Way, a strong current of air blows up from deep inside the tree.
Oh, God. Well, then. That was fun. But that's DDO. Okay, so owl bear butter. And they won't let me go there. Okay. Bears right there. Okay, I got two more items to get. Does this have anything to... Oh. Here. Always. Oh God, that's just right. Okay, so find the gloves of a giant. Nothing there. Okay. See, no secret passages. Well, wait a second. I just, oh God. Ah. Hello, creepy little gnome. I need some owl butter. Just how the hell do you make owlbear butter? Oh God. You milk. Oh God, a gingerbread golem. Oh God.
The gnome baker tells you that he doesn't have any owlbear butter. A gingerbread golem that he created has run off with his entire supply, along with a collection of delectable custard-filled cakes.
Great. Do you know, well, God, I'm having flashbacks to Shrek. Oh, God. I... What the hell?
I'm going to make a old friend army.
Okay. Let's switch over to... God, I cannot believe this. Molasses Kundra.
All that's left of the gingerbread golem is a huge pile of crumbs. Amid his remains, you find a large pot of owlbear butter.
Good lord. Is there anything about the monster manual for that? Gingerbread golem? Great. Oh, God. Okay. Gloves. Gloves of the age. Gloves of a giant. Okay, let's see. Okay. Oh, that's just dumb luck stumbling upon that. All right, so you got him. Okay. Oh, whoa, what was that? Okay. Some weird... Nice. All right, this has got to be the key. Okay. So the deep dive, I gotta go in. Is it here? Nope. Then it's got to be this well. Hold on a second. Bio. All right, sorry about that, everyone. And sorry, you're gonna have to hear me on my inhaler. What was that? Okay. Wait a second. Okay. So okay. So this has got to be take a deep dive or something like that. Okay. Well, I guess that was it. Oh, God. Alright, so just jump in the well, everyone. That's what you gotta do. You gotta jump in the freaking well. Of course, if I had been... Never mind. Doesn't matter, I'm here right now. Oh, that doesn't sound good. Oh, no, because that's a spider. Not just any spider, a touch spider. And once again, where are the goddamn ants? Oh, that's the other thing. In Isle of Dread, we have those intelligent spider-like creatures. I wonder if we're going to see those. Bear traps. Well, that's kind of mean with a polar bear as your bear servant or...
Giants who live in the caverns beneath the Feywild.
Hi. Can I have your gloves? Okay, I gotta do things, right? Well, okay, that makes it things. Getting sick and tired of having to do little errands, you know, and do three things this, three things that.
And they immediately shrink down to your size. their magic, of course.
Of course, that's what happens here. And not only the Feywild, but all of Eberron. Kind of friend of one of my guildies. Oh, don't tell me I gotta. Really? Do I have to go swimming all the way up? What the hell's this? Okay, let's see if I can find a way out through here. Any keys? Doorways. Nope. Okay. Well, I guess I gotta take another swim. Oh, where is that? I just gotta remember to swap that back. Thought I was doing okay against the. I was gonna go up against Bolt Beholder in there in oh. Well, okay, that's. Oh, okay. Okay. Maybe I should apologize to the statue. Oh, screw you, statue. Alright, so, now I know. I know what to do. Got it. Oh. God. Got myself turned around. Okay, I got everything he needs. Everything. Okay. And whoa. Okay, I'm gonna hurry up and where did I go wrong in life? Maybe I should have been content and staying in going to Sharn and nope, sorry. Okay, it will not be. Wait a second. That's the Baron. Oh God. Okay. Is this going to get weird? This is going to get weird. This is going to get weird. He's making it weird. Oh, God. Oh, no.
The bear's mouth and pull out an eladrin.
He turned you into a bear? Oh, God. Not my friend Flicka.
Says he knows a secret that could defeat Hearsack. You should deliver the news to Winter Court. You can use that information to plan your next move.
Okay, Why did he do this? Oh yeah, you may want to get back together with your wife. She's waiting for you. How long did that take? Oh well. All righty. Yes, it always goes back to the okay. 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 Mulberry. Mulberry. I'll talk to Mulberry. Where's Mulberry? Goddamn pixies. Okay, why? Oh, that's why. Okay. Okay, let's let's see what this armor looks like. God, I do not like the look of that. It's ugly. I mean, I like this cosmetic, the scoundrel's leathers, and you can't. Oh, you can't find them anymore. I wish it was in a different color, like a dark blue or a black or something. Do I need to do any enhancements? Oh, yes. Okay. I may have to okay. Alrighty. Oh, let's get to see the Thornwright. Okay, and away I go. Oh no. I'm gonna have people chasing me. And I'm gonna have people chasing me. That's okay. It's fun. Ha 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 ha. turn around. Oh. What the hell? Really? Okay.
A deep voice.
Oh God.
Cabin. Turn back, stranger. Weak reeds are not welcome in my workshop.
Well, that's kind of creepy. And of course, what am I going to do? I'm gonna break into this house. Oh, not his house. Oh, you know what I mean.
A dryad leaps from the tree. Sensing your surprise, she motions for you to speak with her.
Salix.
The dryad calls for the test to begin, and creatures instantly spring to you.
Okay, well, at least I don't have to get owlbear butter and stick my hands down a... We've only just begun.
Gesture and a door opens. A gnarled woodbird carefully picks through a pile of brambles, plucking out the largest and sharpest thorns. Surely this is the thornwright.
Not what I was expecting. Okay, you crafted something from her Sam. Here, Sam. Her Sam. Here, Sam. What is it? Where can I find it? Okay, he paid you for the work, but was there a clause that you gotta keep the secrets?
Needle for Hissom. A needle that now contains Hissom's immortality. The Prince of Status then took that needle to some place called the Treasure Grove.
What was that? Okay. Oh God, oh, it's dear. Okay. Okay. Giga. Needle in the face, Dak. Face stack. That's funny. That's good. That's good. All right. So I think I am going to call it here. All right, everyone, I am going to call it. Thank you so much for watching, especially all of you who came in with Irina's raid. Hope you had a good time and enjoyed having you along. And don't be shy, always. I haven't set a schedule yet for my streaming, but I do DDO and Fallout 4, and I'll probably do. I've been debating about Star Wars: The Old Republic, but right now it's mainly DDO and Fallout 4. I have a lot of those videos up here on Twitch, and I also have a YouTube channel up too as well. So. And on that note, thanks for watching. Enjoy springing forward I hate this time of year, but I'm already wanting to fall back. I haven't even sprung forward yet, but thanks so much for watching. Take care, have a good one, and be seeing you.